आपका हमारे चैनल न्यूज़ ब्लास्ट में स्वागत है। अभी तक आपने हमारा चैनल सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो सब्सक्राइब कर ले, साथ में बेल आइकॉन को दबाना ना भूले ताकि हमारे लेटेस्ट वीडियो की नोटिफिकेशन आप तक पहुंचे।
Some of us would have heard of this referendum 2020, as it's been called, a move really to raise a question for Sikhs whether they want to consider any such thing as a Khalistan, a question thereby whether they want to consider another partition of Punjab, of India, unlikely as this seems. A rally has been planned in London on August the 12th to push this cause, and a counter demonstration has been planned as well. Who is raising this demand and why? Do let's hear from Gurpatwant Pannu, the man behind this campaign. Pannu, you're calling this a referendum, but a referendum is a very specific action undertaken by governments. You really mean an opinion poll, don't you? And that too among a few select people.
No, Sanjay, I don't agree on this issue. Like, it's a non-binding referendum. And most recently, the Punjab independence referendum in the year 2020, we are seeking a non-binding vote. When we say non-binding, that has to be done through the community as propagated in the UN Charter, that all peoples have a right to self-determination. Most recently, Catalonia people, they have done a non-binding. Kurdistan people in Iraqistan have done a non-binding. So this non-binding referendum is a step towards seeking an
official.
But
this is not from Punjab.
This will be in Punjab also, while doing in other 20 countries in which the people of Punjab and the Sikhs have been granted political asylum.
Have you any indications that you will be able to do anything like this in Punjab?
Yes, we are very sure that we will be able to do, and we have devised different ways depending on the
such
how
as
the
what?
Government reacts. First of all, we wanted to do it through the net, that we wanted to have a system based on the internet, but then we have already seen that they're going to shut down the system. Then there is Facebook voting, then there is apps which you can use it. But we
then
are very
we are talking
sure.
about opinion polls, really, you know, and this is informal.
Non-binding referendum is an opinion of the community, of the people, that are you seeking an independence? If you're seeking an independence, we will move ahead and take a step towards the UN.
Right. But what is this seeking to do? Really, are you, and this is difficult to believe, but really, are you looking for another partition of India?
So India was never a full country anyway. Before the British annexed Punjab, Punjab was an independent country. So we are in this opinion building, as you are calling it. We call it a non-binding referendum.
We are not talking about Maharaja Ranjit Singh's Punjab. I mean, that extends to now Pakistan, Kashmir, everywhere.
That's possible that Punjab was big at that time. But all we are seeking right now to re-establish Punjab, whatever is left right now, that should be re-established as a country, because under India's governance, we have seen it in 70 years, Punjab and the Punjabis, whether they are Sikhs, Hindus, Muslims, they will not be prosperous. Economically, genocidal violence has taken place. Even right now, you can see how the drug has been infested into the Punjab.
But Manu, to be polite, you don't think that this is a somewhat unrealistic dream? And do we have any signs that there's a popular movement or support for this within Punjab itself at all?
No, I see it's very realistic, and you're going to see it also that India did the same thing. India was very prosperous under the British rule, and the first movement they started in 1857, but they were successful in 1947. So we are building an opinion, we are building a vote, we are going international, and we are seeking a UN intervention, we are seeking the UN countries backing that Punjab should be re-established as a country.
But you mentioned the UN. Is the UN involved in this at all?
In this particular non-binding referendum, UN is not involved. This is the people's right, whether they want to re-establish Punjab as a separate country or they still wants to be under India's governance.
You have personally had some angst over this issue and similar issues with the Indian government, and there have been some cases against you. What are those cases, and are those provoking you into taking this position?
No, Sanjay, it has nothing to do with me personally. All those false accusations have been done by the Punjab government. Actually, the anger is from the Indian government and the Punjab government, because we were very successful in blocking the visits of all those human rights violators, are the ones who are really establishing those policemen who have.
But did you succeed in blocking any
yes,
visits?
Every time we were successful, you can see the Captain Amarinder was blocked to come to Canada. Even in February of 2018, Captain wanted to come to speak at the Boston University. He wasn't able to come. There is no personal animosity or anger from my side. The charges which they have laid down against me, which I can see it only in the newspaper, is the sedition charges. And they are saying that I am trying to establish Punjab as a separate country, and I am doing that.
But you are a U.S. citizen? Are you a U.S. citizen?
Yes, I am a U.S. citizen.
Right. So why sedition charges in India then?
That you have to ask the government of Punjab and the Indian government why they are charging me for the sedition. And when all I am doing is establishing the right of the people of the Punjab as per the international laws. The Indians have done it in the past, and the British used to file the sedition charges against them. So they should learn something from the history and let the democratic voice of the people of the Punjab and Sikhs have a vote on this one.
You have been reported to have supported militants, so people who are wanted by the police and people who have been pursued by the police. Why this connection? Why are you backing people who take the path of violence?
I'm not backing any of them. I'm a lawyer and I'm a human rights lawyer. If you name anyone who I am supporting, the charges have been filed against some individuals which have been proved to be the false charges. The British government has investigated them, Portuguese government have investigated them, and they didn't find any evidence of their involvement in any crimes in India. So those words which has been used by the Indian government and the file, they have the rule of law. They have the pen and the pencil. They can file charges against anyone, and they can tomorrow they are going to file charges against me. How are we going to prove our innocence? The only way we can prove our innocence is that the British government investigated them, Portuguese government investigated them, there is any evidence.
But there is evidence, and there are so many reports about the police in pursuit of people who have been wanted for violence and militancy and people that you are associated with.
The people are the police of Punjab. I wouldn't say people, I'm saying police of the Punjab and the Indian government are pursuing all those who are seeking independence of Punjab, who are seeking Khalistan. Each and every individual who works for Khalistan or works for the right to self-determination of the Sikhs, they brand them as terrorists. And you can count on the fingers how many have been convicted so far by the Indians in 30 years. You name one that this individual is from UK, US or Canada, that they have been convicted. Everybody have been accused.
But people have been convicted in the UK, and people have been pursued in Hong Kong, and you have been acting on their behalf?
No, the people in Hong Kong you are talking about is Romy. He was involved in that. He was accused of a crime. I went over there not to defend for that particular crime. I went over there to seek the extradition papers to see what are the charges Indians are laying against him. So I'll be, in case I pursue that case, that will be only about the extradition case. Because as we all know, any individual, any Sikh who has been taken by the Indian government are extradited, they have been tortured. There are reports starting from Professor Puller to Deya Singh, everybody has been tortured.
Well, there have been claims made, allegations made, counter allegations, counter claims. But you know, coming to this referendum issue again, there was some sort of a water referendum, wasn't there? That went nowhere?
Of course it went everywhere.
Then we what happened? What was the outcome?
Nobody. We collected 1.3 million votes, and the Supreme Court was supposed to issue the final judgment. Since then, they are not able to issue the final judgment. We were able to educate the people of Punjab that your water is already being plundered and taken by the Indian government on the pretext that SYL canal is not built.
But that is an initiative the Punjab government is taking.
No, we did it. The Punjab government is hand and glove with the central government in 1981 and 1982. It is the same Congress government, it is the same captain who were able to go with Indira Gandhi and dig.
How did you conduct that referendum? Online?
We conducted it online, and we had apps, and plus we had voting booths in Punjab.
Well, that is very clear. Someone says this is an app, this is an option, online or otherwise in a booth, and do you want more water? Of course people will say yes. This issue about Khalistan that you're talking about is quite another matter. You've had so many parties in Punjab who have contested polls speaking about Khalistan. They've gotten nowhere. Simranjit Singh Mann started this. He got nowhere. The popular verdict has been against this.
Sanjay, I'm not a member of Simranjit Singh Mann's group. And I will say one thing, that we do not believe in any leader. We do not believe in any party which runs their elections under the Indian Constitution, whether it is Simranjit Singh Mann or anyone else. I will say one thing. If we all think, and if the Indian government and the Punjab government thinks, there is not any issue of Khalistan, there is not any issue of independence, why would not they let it vote? Why would they file sedition charges? Why would they file terror charges? Why would they pursue the people who are working for right to self-determination? It's easy. If they are democracy, if they are the biggest democracy in the world, why wouldn't they allow a vote to happen? Simranjit Singh Mann's party is running elections under the Indian Constitution. And the people of Punjab has given...
Well, he is not speaking for the Indian Constitution.
People of Punjab has given verdict to them in 1990s to 1992. But after that, the Indian government have suppressed with high-handedness, with the violence, all the voices of freedom in Punjab. Now the people of Punjab wants a government, if they want to run in Punjab, who will be helping them in getting the job.
You know, you're speaking about supposed Khalistan and supposed independence from India, a partition. Do you have memories of what the last partition brought?
I do.
And what it brought to India, what it brought to Punjab?
I will also remind you, Sanjay, there is a book by Paul Bras from Washington University which says genocide of Sikhs and Muslims in 1947. You know who he pointed out to? He pointed out to Nehru, Gandhi, and
there are so many
Patel.
Views.
No.
There
he has documents to prove
sure.
that I mean, the is, violence was
much
conducted.
Much contested debate.
No, it's not contested. The ones who are the historians who have seen it in there,
no,
who have gone through the papers, I'll tell you.
To suggest that Gandhi and Nehru organized the killing of Muslims and Sikhs, this is
if you're
something...
closing the eye, no. If you are closing the eyes and you are the rule of the ruler during that time, you are responsible. Same thing happened in 1984. If Rajiv Gandhi is closing his eyes, do you think he should not be responsible? Nehru, Gandhi and Patel were responsible for what happened to the Sikhs in 1947.
No, I think that violence was widespread. It was chaotic. It
why
was
would,
why terrible.
Would it be? I'll ask you something.
Well,
Sanjay,
I wouldn't say,
I'll ask
wouldn't
you
say.
Something. Who were the majority? Hindus?
I hear you, but that's not a debate we can certainly launch into at the moment. You mentioned 84, and 84 is very significant. There's no doubt that 3,000, more than 3,000 Sikhs were killed in Delhi, that no justice has followed, yes?
Yes.
But let's not forget that what you're talking about, when you speak of Khalistan, say, you're talking about a religious political entity in Punjab, in government. But we've already had the Akali Dal for so long. What did they do?
See, under Indian Constitution, Punjab will not be a free state. Punjab will not be able to have the same laws
and the
rights. But
if the Akali Dal government in Punjab could not speak up for Sikhs, who will?
Akali Dal is hand and glove with the BJP, with the Modi, who wants to run India as a Hindu nation. What are we going to seek from
But they've
Prakash
had
Badal?
Massive mandates in the past. Actor Namrinder Singh has had a massive mandate now.
But how did he
this
come into
the,
power?
This is the expression of popular will, not the
Sanjay,
expressions made to
anyone
you over this issue.
Anyone who owes allegiance to Indian Constitution will not be able to rule Punjab effectively. Punjab is the state which is being economically drowned by the Indian government with an idea to make sure that economically the Sikh community becomes so poor and so dependent that they don't seek their right to vote, they seek their independence.
Let's say
we
you,
must agree all on, the, on this
you,
one.
Let's say that you see this conspiracy, but seeing this conspiracy as...
It's not
you,
a conspiracy, it's practical.
From, let's say your this is your view, this is your understanding of this.
This is a majority
line,
view, Sanjay.
In line with your view and your understanding, would you give up American citizenship and go to Punjab and live there and fight it out there?
Yes.
Why don't you do that now?
Yes, let's do this one. Ask Modi government on the public TV channel. Tell them they will be doing a referendum on January 1st, 2019. I'll give up my...
But
I will give up my U.S. Citizenship. I will give up my life. I will go to village to village in Punjab seeking referendum, seeking independence. Even if I have to give up my life, I will go. Forget about U.S. citizenship.
And
that is nothing for me.
And do you find that a lot of people who are with you or some of the people with you in the U.S., in the U.K. are going to give up their home, their family, their life,
the
here,
campaign,
all the wealth,
the
and leave this all and go to Punjab? Come on, you can't be serious.
No, like
who
you have
will
to be
do
practical.
This?
Let's be practical. How many Hindus are there in Pakistan? Let's take a number.
Look,
68 lakh. They are the richest people. They are richest people in Karachi.
Look,
did they give up their citizenship in Pakistan and went back to India? No. Same thing with the Jewish. Same thing with the Israeli. They rule the world. They have their own nation. They have their own. Everybody is not going to go back. I am vouching for the people who are campaigning for Punjab independence. We will go back and we will make sure if there is an official referendum, you get it done and I'll go with you.
We hear you. I have to say that having met so many Sikhs settled in Britain over many, many years, I don't see anyone leaving the comfort and the security of
that is
home
Sanjay,
and life here
Sanjay,
to head to Punjab to fight politically.
Let's have a vote on this one.
So
that's why
we
are
can go
calling
on,
it a referendum.
Yes.
Let's have even a vote on this one. How many will go back? Let's have a vote on this
we
one.
We can have an opinion poll, but just let's not call it a referendum.
Okay.
Another referendum.
Let's have an opinion poll on this one. How many we will go back?
All right. Maybe that might be worth an opinion poll to ask people how many are ready to go back, and then also to make a commitment how they would go back. It's
See,
easy to say yes.
Is.
Every Indian who moves abroad says, oh, yes, of course, one day I'll go back. Nobody
No,
goes
like
back.
India got the independence series. Every Indian moved back to India.
Well, I mean,
why not?
We can have
let's compare the oranges with the oranges. Not allowed to compare the oranges with the apples.
We can have.
We the Sikh people. We never. I'll tell you something. We the Sikh people. Since 1984, everybody was flourishing in Punjab. You will see a hordes of the Sikh people moving out from Punjab. Why did they move out? Because of the genocidal violence that were committed, because of the suppression of freedom, because of the torture, extrajudicial killings that the Indians government and the political leaders instigated, that's why they moved out. Do
but
you think we will not
out,
go back to our lands?
They moved out to other places in India because they see India as their country where they've made a new home, they're happy. Most Sikhs are still in Punjab. But of course, the grand debate about the world we can have
That's
endlessly.
Why
but on the referendum, do hear your views. Thank you very much for talking to us and for sharing your views.
Thank